What do you do? Keep you guys.
Two, four, five, nine, five, zero.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, all the students. This is your second class in PH 101. Till now 28 students are present, so I have total 45, just waiting a little more. Sheila Bhattacharji, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can you tell what is the differential equation of simple harmonic motion?
D square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to zero.
Okay. And what is the solution of the differential equation? That means x is the solution. I proved the solution.
A sine omega t plus phi.
Okay. So this is your well-known solution that I discussed last day. That is, I discussed what is the differential equation of simple harmonic motion, and from that differential equation, its solution was proved. Okay. Now today,
yes,
I will discuss about the acceleration velocity of the particle executing simple harmonic motion. Okay, and you were saying about the notes, so I will share you the PPT in your group. Okay, whatever I will discuss, I will share the PPT in our group, that is 1 to 45. And after my class, you will send your attendance, and Google form is already there. So while filling up the form, you will write all the digits I shared in your group, that how to write the roll number. Because if anyone is writing only 34 or 44, then when I am arranging the roll numbers, I am not getting the serial. So all are, you have to fill up in the same way. all of you. If you are using the 7 digits of your roll number, then all of you will you have to write the 7 digits. If anyone write the 6 digit or 5 digit, then it will create problem. So I shared the screenshot of the my spreadsheet, Google spreadsheet, whatever you have filled in Google form. So follow that, and according to that, fill up your Google form. Otherwise, I can't arrange the roll number serially for giving attendance. Okay? Clear to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yesterday 46 students were there. Now up to this only 40 students are here. So I'm just waiting 2 minutes more, because if I share the screen, probably I can't allow anyone after this. So I'm just waiting a little more. Your attendance is mandatory in class, because if you are not present, total marks depends, your internal marks depends on attendance. So keep your attendance, proper attendance. And from the next day, it is already 5 minutes over. So after 10, now from tomorrow, be present in your scheduled time. After that, I will not wait. As this is second class, up to first class, second class, or maximum third class, I can wait. But after that, be very, very punctual about your class.
Ma'am.
2.
Present, ma'am.
3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5.
Present, ma'am.
6.
Present, ma'am.
7. 8. Roll number 8.
Present, ma'am.
9.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11. Roll number 11. Roll number 11 absent. 12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21. Roll number 21. 22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am. Present, ma'am.
31.
Yes, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33. Roll number 33. So 33 is absent. 34?
Present, ma'am.
35? Roll number 35.
Present.
36?
Present, ma'am.
37?
Present, ma'am.
38?
Ma'am.
39?
Present, ma'am.
40?
Present, ma'am.
41?
Yes, ma'am.
42?
Yes, ma'am.
43?
Present, ma'am.
44?
Present, ma'am.
45?
Present, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, roll number 21 present.
Roll number 21 present. Okay. So why are you giving response late? You entered late.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm just giving the caution for you all that whenever you have class, be present in your scheduled time. Otherwise, I will start my class, and after I start my class, I will not give attendance to anyone. So for today's class, 11 and 33 absent. Okay. So total 43 students are here. So they will send the attendance in Google form. Now Kanchan Sarkar want to enter. Kanchan Sarkar? Hello? Kanchan Sarkar?
Yes, ma'am.
Why are you late? Don't be late from my next class. Otherwise, I will not give attendance. If I shared the screen as it is my second class, up to first class, second class, and maximum third class, I can wait. But after that, I will not wait. If I share my screen, then I will not allow anyone to enter into my class.
Sorry, ma'am.
So what is your roll number?
11. 11, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So all of you will send your attendance through Google form in proper way. That screenshot is given for the roll numbers, how to write. Don't write in 2 digits. My screen is visible or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So these topics I discussed yesterday. That is what is simple harmonic motion, what is displacement, amplitude, these things. And this is the differential equation for simple harmonic motion. And this is the solution. The solution I proved that x equal to a sine omega t plus phi. This is the solution of the differential equation of SHM. Up to this, I discussed. Now, starting from here today. So the velocity of the particle executing SHM, all these things you know, I think, from a previous class. So here, I have first time calculating the velocity and acceleration. Then now saying that how it varies, velocity and acceleration, how varies. So already we know x equal to a sine omega t plus delta. Initially it was taken as phi, but it is written delta. No problem for this. You can write anything. So x equal to a sine omega t plus delta. Now a particle executing a simple harmonic motion possesses both potential energy and kinetic energy at any instant. The kinetic energy of the particle of mass m moving with velocity v executing SHM, it follows, this is the expression of kinetic energy, TK. TK is the expression of kinetic energy. And you know it, this expression, that is half m omega square x a square minus x square. Is this relation is known to everyone? Kinetic energy is half m omega square a square minus x square, is it? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
What is your name?
I'm Shobhan Nayak.
Okay, so this expression now I'm going to prove. Now x equal to a sine omega t plus delta. Say this is the displacement, equation of displacement. Now v equal to what? V equal to dx by dt. That means velocity equal to dx by dt, the time derivative of displacement. Now if I differentiate this equation, how? A dx by dt, then I will get a omega, then sine omega t will be cos omega t plus delta. Sine omega t plus delta, it remains as cos omega t plus delta, it changes, and in the front it is omega is coming. So this is the expression of velocity. Now already we know the expression of sine omega t plus delta. From here we have to calculate the value of cos omega t plus delta. So cos omega t equal to cos omega t plus delta equal to what? I've calculated here, that is root over 1 minus x square by a square, because cos of omega t plus delta, this is equal to plus minus root over this. Why? Because sine omega t plus delta equal to x by a. So cos square omega t equal to root over 1 minus sine square omega, cos square omega t plus delta equal to root over 1 minus sine square omega t plus delta. So from here we have calculated the value of cos omega t plus delta, and the value is this. Now putting the value here, so this is the value of cos omega t plus delta. Now after calculation, this a cancels. So it is this a square cancels here. This a square, when comes outside, it cancels with this a. So outside it only remains omega. So the expression of velocity is this, plus minus omega root over a square minus x square. This is the expression of velocity. Now kinetic energy, from this we can calculate. How can we calculate kinetic energy? This is half m velocity square. So velocity is already this. So if you take the square of this, then you will get half m, then v square. V square means plus minus sign, it vanishes here because it is that whole square. So omega square is square minus x square. So we are getting this as the velocity, as the kinetic energy of the particle executing simple harmonic motion. Now I am coming to the expression of, now I am coming to the expression of acceleration. Actually acceleration is equal to dv by dt, that is equal to minus a omega square sine square omega t plus delta, because dx dt equal to this, dx dt equal to this, then acceleration is d2x by dt square, that means dv by dt. So if I get the differentiation on this, then what I will get? So again one omega I will get here. So again we, and cos omega t plus delta, when differentiation is given, then it changes to sine omega t plus delta. So minus, with minus sign. So here I'm getting minus a omega square sine omega t plus delta. Actually just what you have to do, that when finding out about acceleration, so when about the acceleration, then what I am doing, d2x by dt square. So again the differentiation of this. So if I differentiate, then I am getting f equal to minus a omega square sine of omega t plus delta. Now what is the value of sine omega t plus delta? This is x by a. So sine omega t plus delta is x by a. So putting the value here. So minus a omega square x by a. So putting the value of sine of omega t plus delta, that is x by a. So a cancels. So ultimately minus omega square x. So this is your one-null equation for acceleration of the particle executing SHM. That is f equal to minus omega square x. And velocity is plus minus omega root over a square minus x square. Now I am discussing how the velocity and acceleration varies. Now when x equal to 0, okay, so I'm coming to velocity. When x equal to 0, this thing is 0, then what is dx dt? Say, when here x equal to 0, what is dx dt?
M 0.
Plus minus omega. Plus minus omega a.
When x plus equal to 0, when x equal to 0, what is dx dt?
Plus minus omega a.
Okay. Plus minus a omega. So this is the maximum value, is it? When x equal to 0, velocity has which value? Maximum value. and it is written here. Say, just look it here. So when x equal to 0, v equal to v max, and this is equal to plus minus a omega. Okay. Now when x equal to a, x equal to 0 means equilibrium position. Now when extreme position I am taking, when x equal to a, what is the value of velocity? When x equal to a, zero. Becomes 0.
Zero.
Zero. So this is minimum.
Zero.
So this is minimum. Now when x equal to a, velocity becomes minimum. So it is written here. So for x equal to not a, so it oscillates, simple pendulum, if I consider for executing SHM. So for x equal to plus minus a, v is v minimum, that is equal to 0. So velocity is maximum at x equal to 0 at equilibrium position having the value plus minus a omega. And for x equal to plus minus a, velocity is minimum, that is 0. This is all about velocity. Now coming about acceleration. So f equal to minus omega square x. Now x is 0, that is the equilibrium position. What is the acceleration? Acceleration is 0. So when x equal to 0, equilibrium position or mean position, f equal to f minimum, that is 0. Now when x equal to plus minus a, then f, that is extreme position, if I take the extreme position, then acceleration is maximum. So acceleration and velocity just opposite to each other. So when at equilibrium position velocity is maximum, then acceleration is 0, and when at the extreme end velocity is 0, then acceleration is maximum. So it in this way velocity and acceleration varies. Now, kinetic energy of the particle that I have already discussed, that is half mv square. So expression you must remember as half m omega square a square minus x square. So this is the expression of kinetic energy for the particle. Now going to the next slide. Now potential energy. Potential energy. Now the expression here in this slide, I am going to discuss the relation between kinetic energy and potential energy with the total energy. Actually, total energy is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So the graph is shown here, that is energy versus displacement graph. And here in y-axis, energy is plotted, that is total energy is plotted. And in x-axis, displacement is plotted. It is x equal to 0 and it is x equal to plus a, this position, x equal to plus a. And this position x equal to minus a. Now the graph of kinetic energy is this. This is the graph of kinetic energy and this is the graph of potential energy. Now this is why this is the nature of the graph of the energy of kinetic and potential energy, that it is clear from the expression of total energy. Now total energy, this is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. Now this is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So kinetic energy expression, this is half m omega square a square. Kinetic energy plus potential energy, that is half m omega square a square minus x square. This is the expression of kinetic energy and this is the expression of potential energy. This is half m omega square x square. So this is the expression of potential energy. It is coming from here. The expression of potential energy, integration 0 to x m omega square x dx, that is equal to half m omega square x square. Now this is the expression of potential energy. So if I add this to energy, kinetic and potential, the expression is half m a square omega square. That is, we can say this is constant, no variable quantities here. So this is the expression is constant. Now from here, we can say about the graphs, that is total energy is always constant. Now kinetic energy expression is this. So when this is the expression of kinetic energy, now when x equal to 0, then kinetic energy is maximum. So this is x equal to 0, this position x equal to 0, what is the value of kinetic energy? This point. Say this is the maximum point. So this is the maximum value of kinetic energy. But when x equal to plus minus a, then kinetic energy is 0. So kinetic energy, this is the energy plotted along the y direction. So kinetic energy, it is the zero position. So in y axis, in this axis, if I take this x-axis, then in x-axis, the value of energy is zero. Actually, x-axis is the displacement axis. And here, the value of total energy is zero. That is the actually energy is plotted along the y direction. So this is the first time that we are plotting the kinetic energy. So in this point, the value of kinetic energy is zero. This is the minus A point and this is the plus A point, because the kinetic energy is half m omega square A square minus x square. So for x equal to plus minus A, kinetic energy vanishes. So this is the point and this is the point. But when x equal to zero, kinetic energy is maximum. So this. So if I add these points, and in between, if you put any value between zero to A and zero to minus A, you will get all the points inside this graph. So actually, if we add all these points, we will get the graph like this. So this is the graph of kinetic energy. Now next, potential energy. So potential energy is half m omega square x square. So x, if it is zero, then this is the zero position, then potential energy is zero. So this is the value of potential energy is zero. And if x equal to plus minus A, the potential energy is maximum. So potential energy, this is the maximum point for potential energy. So this is maximum potential energy for x equal to plus A. And this is the maximum value of potential energy for x equal to minus A. So if I add these points, I will get the graph like this. So this is the graph of, it is shown, this is the graph for potential energy. So in this way, always that energy is constant, conserved. So when kinetic energy is maximum, then potential energy is zero. And when potential energy is maximum, kinetic energy is zero. And as a whole, the total energy remains constant. And the value is half m omega square, half m a square omega square. So this is the value of total energy. This remains as constant. Now some illustrations of simple harmonic motion. So motion of a simple pendulum. Now this figure is known to you all. A simple pendulum of length L, it is shown here. The simple pendulum of length L is displaced from its main position. So I'm taking here this position. This position is the main position. That is A position. And displaced from its main position A, and it is allowed to oscillate with an angular displacement less than 4 degree. So it is the angular displacement theta, it is less than 4 degree. Let at instant t, it is at point P. So let at any instant t, the pendulum is at any point P. And AP, that is x. So this is the displacement. So here AP equal to x. Now angular amplitude theta, that is the here, that is the theta, the relation between x and theta. Theta, we can write it as x by L. So if it is x and if it is L and this is equal to theta, is AP is x and OA is L, then if this value is theta, then mathematically we can write theta equal to x by L. Now, how theta we can write x by L? Can anyone say?
Ma'am, because it's a if it's a displacement,
perpendicular by
sine theta equals x by L, and theta is small, so sine theta is equal to theta.
Now, what is this? AP by L equal to what? AP by OA. According to the triangle OAP, what we can say?
And perpendicular and this.
AP by OA. What is this?
Tan theta.
Tan theta. Okay. From where? Then from here, if theta is small, then what I can write? From here, theta equal to x by L. Okay, because tan theta equal to what? Sine theta by?
Cos theta.
Then if theta is small, then sine theta equal to?
Sine
equal to theta and cos theta equal to?
One.
So in place of tan theta, what I can write? Theta. Is it? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So say this triangle OAP. We are considering this triangle. So OAP is here X, OA is L, and this angle is theta. So tan theta equal to right, you can write X by L, and from here tan theta again sin theta by cos theta, and if theta equal to small, sin theta equal to theta and cos theta equal to 1, so we can write this thing X theta equal to X by L. Now this is the relation between theta and X. Now the weight mg, which is vertically downward, is resolved into following components. That these things already known to you, that is mg is acting downward in this way. So this is theta, where this component, this angle is theta, so it is mg cos theta, and this is mg sin theta. Force acting along the string and balances the tension T of the string. So this is the tension is balanced by this one. Now force acting perpendicular, and it is only force acting on the bob of the pendulum towards the, and now this is the mg sin theta, that is acting on the bob of the pendulum. Now what we can write from here? F equal to minus mg sin theta. Now this is the force that is acting on the bob of the pendulum, because the tension is balanced by mg cos theta. Now this is the force remaining. So F equal to minus mg sin theta. Now if theta is small, then we can write sin theta equal to theta. Then from here, F equal to minus mg theta. And force and displacement, this is opposite. So we have given the minus sign. This is the retarding force that brings the pendulum back to its initial position. Now from this expression, F equal to minus mg theta. So I have written force equal to minus mg theta. Now if I write F by M, that is equal to minus G into theta. So given it equation number 1. So F by M, force by mass, that is equal to minus G into theta. Now again, that I have proved X equal to L theta. That means already I have proved theta equal to X by L in the previous slide. So X equal to L into theta. Now if I take the differentiation dx by dt, so dx by dt equal to L into d theta by dt, first time differentiating, then again second time differentiating. So d2x by dt square equal to L into d2 theta by dt square. So X equal to L theta. We are differentiating this expression twice with respect to t. So this is our equation number 2. Now comparing 1 and 2. Actually F by M, what is this? F equal to what? Force equal to mass into acceleration. So force by mass equal to what? Acceleration. Okay. So left hand side, equation 1, left hand side is acceleration. Actually, this is acceleration, F by M. And again, dx by dt square is acceleration. So I am just, this is dx by dt square equal to acceleration. F by M is equal to acceleration. So the left hand side of equation 1 and 2 is same. So we can write that this thing equal to this one. That is L into d2 theta by dt square equal to what? What? Minus g into
minus theta.
Okay. So F by M equal to minus g theta. This is acceleration. And d2x by dt square, this is itself acceleration. So just equating, comparing these two equations. So right hand side, this equal to this right hand side. So L d2 theta by dt square equal to minus g into theta. Then after that simple calculation I have done. So d2 theta by dt square equal to what? Minus g by L into theta. Or d2 theta by dt square equal to this g by L is your omega square that I am taking. G by L equal to omega square. So omega equal to root over g by L. So omega equal to root over g by L and omega square equal to g by L. So given the value here, so left hand side as it is, this is equal to minus omega square into theta, where omega equal to this. Now if omega equal to root over g by L, then t equal to what? Time period of oscillation equal to 2 pi by omega, is it? Time period of oscillation equal to what? 2 pi by omega.
Yes, ma'am.
So, t equal to 2 pi root over L by G. So, what is this expression? This is the expression of time period.
Time period.
Simple harmonic motion. Okay. Yes, and what is the differential equation for simple pendulum? This one. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
2 theta plus dt squared plus omega squared theta equal to 0. This is the differential equation for simple pendulum. Initially, it was when I started simple harmonic motion, it was written that d2x by dt squared plus omega squared x equal to 0. Now here, in the place of x, it is theta. This is the angular displacement. So this is displacement, but this is angular displacement. So this is the differential equation for simple harmonic motion for simple pendulum. So from here, we can prove that simple pendulum executes SHM because it is satisfying the equation for SHM, the differential equation for SHM. So d2 theta plus dt squared plus omega squared theta equal to 0. This is the expression of, this is the differential equation for simple pendulum for executing SHM. And this is the time period of oscillation. In this way, for different system, you can find out. Now, oscillation of liquid in a U-tube, actually, I'm not discussing this example. So I will give it in note, you will read it. And whenever, if you have any problem, then you will ask, you can ask in my next class. If I get time today, then I will discuss this. Now I'm going to my next one. This is new for you. This is oscillation in LC circuit, electrical circuit. Electrical circuit also executes simple harmonic motion. That I'm going to prove because this is new one for you.
Ma'am, new chapter.
No, these are all the examples of simple harmonic motion. This is the chapter of simple harmonic motion, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Whatever I have discussed differential equation of SHM and its solution. And for different, these are the examples, actually. Examples of simple harmonic motion. First example is a simple pendulum. Second example is oscillation of liquid in U-tube. You have done this problem. That oscillation, liquid oscillates in U-tube, and this is the time period of oscillation. And you can see here, d2x by dt square plus omega, that is equal to this one. I have proved, actually, the d2x by dt square plus omega, this sign is plus, actually. This is a mistake is here. I will correct it. So d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. So this is, again, the equation of simple harmonic motion, differential equation. So from here, this is the angular velocity that is given, and time period of oscillation is calculated. So this is the expression, and this is the example that in a U-tube containing a liquid, pressure is applied on the liquid column in one arm of the tube and then released, the liquid column will begin to oscillate in a simple harmonic manner. So what will be the time period of oscillation and what will be the value of omega that I have given? So go through it. It is very easy. If I get time today before 10:50, then I must discuss this one. But coming to this oscillation in LC circuit, consider, this is new one for you, so listen it very carefully. So consider an electrical circuit involving an inductor of L Henry's. So this is inductor of L Henry's, a capacitor of C farads. So this is the capacitor C farads. When the capacitor is charged externally, or the inductor is influenced with the help of the magnet, then there will be current through the circuit, which varies with time. So current is flowing. Whenever the capacitor is charged externally, the inductor is influenced by the help of the magnet, then there will be current through the circuit. So current is passing now. And now this is the key. This is the cell is attached. Now voltage across inductor. The voltage across inductor is V equal to L into di by dt. I equal to what? The current passing through the circuit. So L into di by dt, that is the voltage across the inductor. The inductor means this one. The voltage across the inductor is L di by dt. It is here smaller. This is same. Huh? Actually, considered the same. Because when, where I have given this, taken this figure, there it was written only a small I. So this is same here. Both I are same. So L di by dt, this is from the voltage across the inductor. This is written. Now V, voltage equal to Q by C. Voltage equal to Q by C, that we know. Q equal to V into C. This is the charge, this is the capacitance. Then current equal to what? dQ by dt. dt of Q, that we write it as current. So I equal to dQ by dt. Now dt is here. Now in place of Q, what I will write? Q equal to what? Anyone say?
C into V.
C into V. So in this place of Q, what I have written? C into V. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So I equal to dq by dt. Do you know this expression? I equal to dq by dt?
Yes,
rate
ma'am.
Of charge? Okay.
Yes.
I
yes,
equal ma'am. To dq by dt. Now Q equal to again Cv. So written here Cv inside the bracket. Now C is constant. I am putting it outside. Now dt of V. So dv by dt. This is dv. Voltage. This is voltage. So I equal to what? C into dV by dt. Now, L into di by dt plus from Kirchhoff's law, we can write L into di by dt plus Q by C equal to zero. From Kirchhoff's law, we can write this one. Now, this I equal to what? I equal to again what? Now what I'm doing here, so this is the expression of differentiating. L into, it is already written, di by dt. Differentiate again with respect to t. So L into d2i by dt square. So di by dt remains as d2i by dt square after differentiation. And q, again differentiating with respect to ddt. So ddt of q equal to what?
I.
So in this place of Q, I have written I. So after differentiating this equation, I'm writing L into d2i by dt square plus I by C equal to zero. Now just writing it in this way, d2i by dt square plus I by LC equal to zero. So what is this expression? Is it the differential equation of SHM?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
As it is electrical circuit, so in place of x, initially it was x. Now for the case of simple pendulum, it was theta. Now as it is electrical circuit, I have written it as I. So d2i by dt square plus I by LC equal to zero. So this is the differential equation of simple harmonic motion for LC circuit, electrical LC circuit. Now from here, what is omega? That is d2i by dt square plus omega square I equal to zero. So omega square equal to 1 by LC. So omega equal to root over 1 by LC. Okay. So this is the value of omega. So what is the time period of oscillation? 2 pi by omega. So t equal to 2 pi root over LC. So this is the time period of oscillation for LC circuit. So electrical LC circuit executes SHM. From here, because it is satisfying the differential equation of SHM, so it is executing SHM. So here, the current is what? Across the inductor is L di by dt, is it? And
yes,
here, Q by, so this is, we can write from the, what we have done? We have used Kirchhoff's law. And I have written this thing. Then after differentiating, I'm getting this expression, the expression of differential equation for simple harmonic motion. And in between, I have used some equations that V equal to Q by C, I equal to dQ by dt. And then putting here, differentiating, ultimately we are getting the expression omega equal to 1 by root over LC. That is T equal to 2 pi root over LC. So this is the expression of time period of oscillation. So you may get from here that any numerical problem you can get L value, C value may be given. Find out the time period or find out the value of omega. Have I time remaining anything? Then I'm going 5 minutes remaining. Okay. I'm going to the oscillation of this one. Oscillation of a liquid in U-tube. So this is U-tube. I already said that in U-tube containing a liquid, if pressure is applied on the liquid column in one arm of the tube, then released, the liquid column will begin to oscillate in a simple harmonic manner. Alpha is the cross-sectional area of the arms of the U-tube. Alpha is the cross-sectional area that I am taking. And the liquid in one limb be depressed by X. So it was initial position. Now it is depressed by X. See, the liquid is depressed by X due to applied force F. The liquid on the other arm will rise by X. Actually, it was the initial position. It was the initial position, this level. This is the initial position. Now, this limb, that is this side, is depressed. The liquid is X by X. Now, in this side, it is increasing by X. So, it will total balance. It will be balanced. So, if it is decreasing, then in this side, it will increase by X. The difference in levels between two arms is 2X. So, what is the difference of level between the liquid of the two arms? This is X plus X. This is 2X. So, this is the difference. It is here in this limb, in this column. And it is here. So what is the difference from this one, from this horizontal line to this? This is 2x. Clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So in this side, in this part, the liquid is here. And this, in this part, liquid is here. So this is the level, horizontal level here. And this is this level for this side. So total is 2x. Due to the weight, 2x of height of liquid column, the liquid column of the two limbs will tend to come to the same level. Now it will try to come to the same level. Hence, the force responsible for motion of the liquid column is this one, F equal to minus 2x alpha rho g. So this is the force. So force equal to, you know, this is m into g. So this is g, this is rho, and this is volume. Understand?
Ma'am, rho is density.
Rho is the density. Rho is the density. So what is, this is the difference, now 2x. 2x is the total difference. So 2x is here. The force due to that 2x length, now it will create. And that will try to bring the liquid column to the same level. Now 2x, this is written here. So this is into alpha is cross section. So 2x into alpha, is it volume? Clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
2x alpha,
yes,
ma'am. Is it volume?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So x into alpha is volume. So here it is 2x for the total this side. So 2x into alpha, this is volume. So volume into density. What is this? Mass.
Mass.
Mass. Yes. Mass m into g. So we can write the force.
Yes. Okay. Ma'am.
So this is the force. Hence, the force responsible for the motion of the liquid column is this. Okay. Now that I have written the mass of the liquid, this is L. That if I write this, L is the height of the total liquid column of the U-tube. That if it is L, then I can write L alpha into rho. So if mass of the liquid is total, that means L I'm taking as the height of the total liquid column in the U-tube. Then L into alpha is again the volume, and this is density. So this is mass. As a whole, this is mass. So L alpha rho, this is mass. D2x by dt square, what? This is acceleration. So this is mass, this is acceleration. So this is, this side is again force. Understand? This is left hand side is force. L alpha rho, this is mass. D2x by dt square, acceleration. So mass into acceleration is what? Force. So left hand side is force, that you know. And this one, minus 2x alpha rho g. This one, minus 2x alpha rho g. This is again the force I have calculated. Now, we are equating this two. So, this one is equal to this one. So, from here, if you calculate, you will get d2x by dt square. Just simplify. d2x by dt square plus 2g by L into x equal to 0. So, omega square equal to what? Omega square equal to 2g by omega square equal to 2g by L. So, omega, sorry here, omega square, it is 2g by L only. So, I will correct it. So, omega equal to root over 2g by L. Is it? Omega equal to root over 2g by L. It will not is omega square. It is actually omega. While type at the time of typing, it is mistake. So, omega equal to root over 2g by L because omega square equal to 2g by L. Now, what is the time period? Omega is root over 2g by L. So, 2 pi by omega. So, 2 pi root over L by 2g. Okay? So, L is here. What I have done here, I will correct this L and this L is same. So, this if I write it here, capital L, then I will must give it here a capital L. So, this is no problem. So, T equal to 2 pi root over L by 2g. And L is what? L is the height of the total liquid column of the U tube. Understood? So, in this way, the differential, it is again satisfying the differential equation for SHM. So, what is the differential equation for SHM? This is d2x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. Omega is root over 2g by L. So, the liquid and the U-tube that begin to oscillate in a simple harmonic manner. So, this is proved. And this is the length L. This is shown here. This is the total length L, height of the, that it is written here. Let L is the height of the total liquid column of the U-tube. In, don't be confused, in some books it is written as 2L, in this side it is taken as L. In some books you will get this portion, that means here in this side L, in this side L, so it is 2L. They take it total liquid length of the total liquid column as 2L. Now, they are expressing this in their figure in that way. But here I have taken the total length of the liquid column as total length of the liquid column as L, capital L. I have not taken it to L. But the total length that I am taking as L. So, in some books, you may be confused with that L. In some books, it may be written 2L. 2L means from one side L and from another side L. So, for that 2L and my total capital L is equal actually. The concept is different here that they are taking as 2L, that length, and I am taking the total length as L. So, for YouTube, it is also executing the liquid that is executing simple harmonic motion. So, today I have discussed what? Today I have discussed the velocity and acceleration of the particle executing SHM, the expression of total energy and the graphs of kinetic energy and the potential energy. Then some examples of simple harmonic motion, that is the simple pendulum. I have proved it executes SHM from the differential equation. Then oscillation of a liquid in U-tube. It also executes simple harmonic motion. The time period is given by this. And oscillation in LC circuit, it also executes SHM. And this is the time period of oscillation for LC circuit. Now, I'm ending my class here. It is already 10:54. Okay. So, next class, the link will be given in your group. But go through the notes. I will send you the notes. Prepare your notes every day. Don't leave it that I will do it ever next day or the very next day. Not in this way. So, day to day, you will prepare the notes and the topics. I will ask in my class to anyone, any question related to the previous class. And must be present in every class. Okay, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, I am just ending my class for today. And already the Google form is there. So, you will send your attendance.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So ending my class for today. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
And sending you the PPT in your group.
Okay.